Hi, I'm Scott Wolf, and I want to tell you about a group at Disneyland in the 1950s and 1960s that was as popular as any attraction, the Elliott Brothers and the Disneyland Date Nighters.
Let's dance at Disneyland. Date nights are late nights at Disneyland.
We're open till the clock rocks
1 a.m. Friday and Saturday nights.
For Disneyland's first 2 years, it was primarily a daytime park. But in the summer of 1957, it would begin nighttime operation for the first time. June was the start of Date Nite. Couples could purchase Date Nite discounted tickets, which permitted admission only after 5 p.m., and they could stay until midnight, and the next year, 1 a.m., as you just heard in that audio clip. Disneyland encouraged dating couples to come experience the park by romantic moonlight, and to enjoy Disneyland's first fireworks display, Fantasy in the Sky. Carnation Plaza Gardens by the castle was the chosen central date night gathering place, and the local Elliott Brothers band were brought in as the Date Nighters, featuring Lloyd and Bill Elliott. Lloyd's daughter Holly gave me this rare postcard picturing the Elliott Brothers and the Disneyland Date Nighters at Plaza Gardens. The Elliott Brothers' wide variety of music styles meant there was something for everybody. They could perform the latest rock songs, big band songs, songs for fast dancing, slow dancing, and even sentimental classics. One newspaper in 1956 said their band had a complete library of rumbas, sambas, congas, mixer dancers, and other novelties. And they did. After all, they were seasoned musicians when they started their own band in 1949, and they called it the Elliott Brothers Orchestra because they felt Elliott was easier to say than their given last name, Elliott. Besides leading their own band, Bill and Lloyd were fantastic musicians on their own, appearing on multiple records and TV and film soundtracks. Even while working at Disneyland, they were involved in countless classic studio recordings. Between them, they performed and recorded with many superstars of their time, like Nat King Cole, Dean Martin, Bing Crosby, Neil Diamond, and Frank Sinatra, just to name a few. Bill and Lloyd both performed in the soundtrack for the epic movie Around the World in 80 Days. Lloyd played in movie soundtracks like My Fair Lady, West Side Story, and he was still playing in the 90s. He played trombone in the 1994 Disney classic The Lion King. He played on the soundtracks for Jaws, Close Encounters, and the last film he worked on was Elf. Bill played bass clarinet, saxophone, and contrabass saxophone, which is a huge instrument. He played that in Journey to the Center of the Earth and Fantastic Voyage. Bill also played in South Pacific, How the West Was Won, The King and I, and The Sound of Music, and that's just a small sampling of their work. I want to play a clip of a much more rare recording that they released as the Elliott Brothers. This was from 1953, before Disneyland had been open. The song is In the Mood, and it's sung by Thurl Ravenscroft. Now, if you've ever been in the Haunted Mansion, you've heard and you've seen Thurl. He's the one that sings this.
Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
He's also heard in the Tiki Room, Country Bear Jamboree, Pirates of the Caribbean, and other Disney attractions and a lot of Disney movies. Listen to this great clip of Thurl Ravenscroft and the Elliott Brothers.
In the mood, that's it, I've got it, in the mood. Your ear was spotted in the mood. Oh, what a hothead, be alive and get the jive, you've got to learn how.
When the Elliott Brothers Band started performing at Disneyland, they were a smash hit. Whether it was the big band festivals, Dixieland to Disneyland events, date nights, grad nights, or New Year's Eve parties, the Elliott Brothers were a big part of it all. Here's Bill and Lloyd and their band featured in the Main Street section of a televised Disneyland parade in 1959.
That's the Elliott Brothers Band on the omnibus, while the horse car ballet takes place on each side. These are the Disneyland Date Nighters. They provide the beat for teenagers and all ages at Disneyland summer night dancing parties.
Bill's son Ryan sent me these photos of his dad's Mouser Award that he received following one of Disneyland's big band festivals. It reads, Disneyland Big Band Festival to Bill Elliott, gratefully, Walt Disney. Those Mousers were Walt Disney's version of the Oscars. He awarded them to people who he felt made a major contribution to the company. In this photo, Lloyd and Bill were receiving these piano awards as a thank you from Walt for participating in the second annual Cavalcade of Big Bands event at Disneyland. These are some of the most legendary big band people. There's Walt Disney at the left, then Bill, Lionel Hampton, legendary drummer Gene Krupa, then Les Brown, Charlie Barnett, and then Lloyd. Ryan also sent me these photos of his dad's piano. It's not just a memento, it was also an AM radio. You know, those cavalcades of big bands and the big band festivals were so popular. During its run, you could see multiple great bands on a single night, not only at Plaza Gardens, but throughout the entire park. Simultaneously, there would be the biggest name big bands playing in the Oaks Tavern in Frontierland, the Golden Horseshoe also in Frontierland, the 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea stage in Tomorrowland, and even aboard the Mark Twain Riverboat. Because of their ability to play so many styles of music, the Elliott Brothers were also involved in things like Dixieland at Disneyland. That event featured some of the greatest names in jazz. Bill's daughter Robin sent me this photo from 1960 of all the Disneyland entertainers, and she was there when they took that photo. There's the Mariachi Gonzalez Trio, and below them is the Dapper Dan's Barbershop Quartet with their bicycle built for four. There's Mickey and Minnie and the Golden Horseshoe Review cast and band. You could also see the mermaids that would swim around the submarine lagoon. At the top is the Disneyland band and band leader V.C. Walker. There's some more Disneyland characters. At the far right, there's Bill and Lloyd in white jackets along with the Disneyland Date Nighters. In 1962, the Elliott Brothers were featured in a couple episodes of the live television series Meet Me at Disneyland on KTTV. Sadly, I don't believe any video of those shows exist, but they were also featured on an episode of Walt Disney's Wonderful World of Color entitled Disneyland After Dark.
This is the Plaza Gardens where the Elliott Brothers hold wide open house, and they really keep the place jumping, believe me.
Disneyland After Dark showcased the live music performed throughout the entire park and concluded with a wonderful glimpse at the Elliott Brothers at Carnation Plaza Gardens during the height of their popularity. Disneyland crowds loved when they performed at La Raspa, better known as the Mexican Hat Dance, which they would play and mix in a variety of other songs throughout it.
Thank you very much. Now we'd like to invite you all to dance the La Raspa.
Here's a photo of one of Bill's Disneyland jackets that he wore while leading the band. A true piece of Disneyland history. You can see that great Disneyland Date Nighters patch on it. Here's a few photos of Bill at Disneyland's Plaza Gardens. By this point, Walt had passed away, and Lloyd had so much studio work that Bill had taken over the band, and it was Bill Elliott and the Disneyland Date Nighters. Bill also had plenty of studio work, but it might have been easier for him because, as an airplane pilot, he flew to Disneyland each day, avoiding the crowded freeways. You know, staying open at nighttime with entertainment like the Elliott Brothers and Fantasy in the Sky fireworks was so groundbreaking that it paved the way for other nighttime entertainment like the Main Street Electrical Parade and Fantasmic. Today, Plaza Gardens is Fantasy Fair, and sometimes they still have big band music there. While the look is quite different, the stage remains, and I still love visiting and knowing all the history that happened there. The Elliott Brothers were beloved by Disneyland guests, and that popularity led to this 1958 record album, Date Nite at Disneyland, where they performed their most requested songs. It's been digitized, and you could hear it on services like Apple Music and Spotify. It really captures the feel of the Elliott Brothers at Disneyland, complete with audience, which is a real treasure because they were truly an integral part of Disneyland history.
This is Lloyd
and Bill Elliott thanking you very much for a wonderful evening and looking forward to seeing you very soon here at Disneyland.